Feature Friday.
The freshest.
Tony Gonzaga.
Yeah, this is her first time. She is actually an MC.
Yeah, she is host of the Philippines host? Voice.
Yeah, she does a lot of things.
Do apologize if I am mispronouncing her name or also, just getting a bunch of information incorrect. Do educate us in the comment if you wish to. We do read every comment.
But you guys were very adamant for us to watch this video specifically, so let's have a look.
Yeah, it seems every MC sings there, so.
Oh, it's kind of wild.
Again, I'd like to like what they serve you in the water.
Yes. So this is Catch Me, I'm Falling.
Tony.
I love mix. I love the old mix too. So atmospheric.
Ta-da.
Oh yeah. Oh girl!
That's an MC dude, what the fuck?
I feel something that seems so right.
Ooh, wow, it's hard.
Like an easy song, do they?
This song is so difficult. It's so weird. It's like jazzy, but it's not really. But it's pop, but it's not really.
Because you made jazz decisions at the start. Well, but then it evolved.
I think the song itself, the chord progressions are actually pushing her in that direction. It's an interesting song. It's a really hard one.
And there she kind of tried to maintain more like a mainstream sound. But at the start, it's so off-stream, it's so
alternative, jazzy. Yeah, I would love to hear a jazz album from her. I think she's got that jazz vocal tonality to it.
I don't even know what genre this is. This is so weird.
Oh no, I can't pin it down here, but her vocal tonality would work fantastically well in jazz.
Yes.
Like old school brushes, like type of jazz, chilled out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hard song to learn.
Indeed.
Catch me, I'm falling for you. How can time be so wrong for love to come along?
More linear, okay, that's fine.
Catch me, I'm falling for you. If I could just walk away without you from day to day, I would die just thinking of you.
Now, my question is, someone who's sort of is willing to take on a challenge like this. I don't know if that's her original song.
Yeah, I was gonna say, who composed this? Because this is a really clever track.
Yeah, it's evolving to a more linear sort of evolution, which is good because.
But it maintains its intricacies.
I think it's because of her, really. Mm-hmm. I think it's she's sort of maintaining this, what made it. Kind of
edge that you're getting, it's provided by her,
that what sort of caused that shock factor. She's the one maintaining that, but at the start it was the musicians maintaining, so because of the chord progressions, but that's turned more linear. But I do wonder, like, when you were able to do things like this, is this perhaps another route in the Philippines where you can, you know, to sort of to pursue a career, to become an MC, and because also maybe she's really good behind the mic as well, obviously she must be, in the sense of hosting, and maybe she's very charismatic and has a personality that shines on TV.
Most likely,
but yeah. is this because if you can do that, right, you're genuinely a musician, you know you can sing. That's always my question, like, you know, with Vice, with Kay Brosas, it's like, why decide on, you know,
why make the choices they have taken in their careers?
Because I guess both of them are at the same level.
Uh-huh.
In the sense of the skill.
Yeah, that's right.
It's like, you know, to be a great comedian, maybe she's a great comedian, and then she's also a great singer. So it's like, why
choose one over the other? Well, the thing is, like, in the Philippines, I've come to realize that both things are quite intertwined in any of those skills.
They're not mutually exclusive.
Yeah, exactly. So you end up singing a lot as you're emceeing a lot, as you're a host of many shows.
Would you say so?
Yeah, I think so. I believe so. The more, based on a very, very shallow knowledge I got from the Filipino
music,
industry. Entertainment industry. You see it in the host, that they vocalize, they sing, they take part, they also are open to do gigs that are exclusively just for singing, as well as they're, you know, hosting of TV shows and stuff. So to me, it's like I don't see it as like, oh, I have to make a choice, I have to let one go to pursue the other. At least not in the Filipino industry. Like we're used to that.
Like for example, back home.
Yeah.
Gotta choose one.
Yeah, exactly. You can't do both, unless you're a superhuman. You can't be keeping up a TV schedule as well as a gigging tour schedule. Very rarely, right? So it's and if there were artists that could do both, they would take a year to do something, and then the next year they would do something else. But
because there were a few, like El Conde del Huacharo, yes, he mixed music with his he had a band, didn't he?
With his comedy show, yeah. Yes. But then again, when he was doing TV scheduling, that whole year was promoted. It was dedicated only for TV work and media work. And when he was touring, then it was
true.
So it was never like one interlinked into the other. You know what I'm saying?
True, true. Yeah, that gets it right. I know we can never be more than friends, you and me.
But why do I feel this way? Is that hard that? Song? Catch me, I'm falling for you, and I don't.
See, it's like, why would you make that choice? Because that's a choice made on purpose by the arrangement.
That's right.
She had no free will there. It's already been set like that. So what the fuck? Can I just check something? I want to see if that's actually her original song. Obviously, that would intrigue me even more if it was her who wrote it and arranged it.
Mm.
But
I like the tonality, the edge of
diphonic
touch to her vocals.
She also acts, mate.
Oh, really? I'm telling you, there
people are a lot
more rounded.
She acts a lot. Jesus. And she has a sister.
Oh, wow, cool.
Alex Gonzaga, who also is a Filipino television host.
Ah, how fun.
Actress, singer, comedian, entrepreneur, vlogger, author. She also can breathe underwater.
Oh, wow. She's got it all. Mermaid in her past life. Yeah. Love that. So, yeah, I actually believe that her vocal tonality, like that edge of diphonic touch to her vocals, are so nice. Gives her so much personality to the way that she's singing. It's really nice. I don't actually know how to put it. The song is really difficult, though. There's a lot of suspense happening in the musical progression.
She signed with a star.
Ah.
And also
Star Music PH.
She went to university.
Oh, wow.
The Philippines Open University. I wanted to study what? Because now I'm intrigued.
Yeah.
Career, personal life. Because that's very intriguing because, yeah, if she sort of made that choice like that, yeah, that requires...
Maybe the song was composed for her?
For someone, yeah, I don't know.
Also, it's somebody else's original song, and they just arranged
it. Not to bang on about it, but that it's impressive. You know,
it is a really cool. Weird. It's a really cool arrangement, though. It's a really good composition, and she really delivered really well.
It's out of the ordinary, because you know she may not have like the craziest range, right? But that's what you must do in order. Then you can still get head turns. You can still create mind blowing moments if you
without having to over deliver or be any. Any flashy whistle note singer.
Play you can to your strengths.
Absolutely.
You know?
And really take advantage of it.
And that seems to be one of her strengths. Do quirky things with music. And
it's
also
nice. Provide... It's refreshing.
Yeah. So anyways, let us know maybe what you thought about it. And who else we should check out next. Or what other work from Tony should we check out next.
Yeah, that's right.